Hello. I've received many questions from women in particular about this kind of bulking up through the repetition of the practice and the many vinyasas and the sort of getting bigger in the upper body and tightening of the shoulders and things like this. And so I have a few ideas about it that I want to share with you. One is let's think of possible reasons why this is happening, this bulking up. And what I come up with is, number one, is possibly there's not enough core strength. And so you're having to compensate with the arms. And so to address the core strength, there's ways to do it that don't involve the jump back and jump through transition, which is known for core strengthening, but then it also might possibly be bulking you up as well. So ways to build the core strength, one is through the breathing. So being very thorough in your breath will actually tone the deep muscles in the core. Number two is that deep breathing leads to bandhas. So getting a feeling for activating the pelvic floor, for uddiyana bandha, for lifting up the navel, and associating the action of those lower bandhas with the end of the exhalation. Practicing Navasana more than 5 times, really taking on that practice will build core strength. And then also being clearer about aligning your positions from your center. Okay, so not enough core strength is a possible reason for bulking up. Number two is a misalignment in the positions that require strength. So, and that's translating into inefficient muscle use. So that includes jumping back and jumping through and Chaturanga Dandasana. To really study the form and how you're executing those positions, economize and clarify the skeletal alignment in order to more efficiently use the muscles, and then they won't bulk up like that. Number three is that it is the most common conclusion, which is there's too much repetition. It's just too many times, and it's tightening you up, and it's, you know, giving you that ungainly look. So that in that case, then you can modify. You can do jump back only between postures, not between every side. And so get some relief. Don't feel that you're stuck needing to continually do vinyasas and more than is suitable to your body and your circumstances right now. So there's those three. And in that line too is that I would see new possibilities for what constitutes strength building in the postures. It's not only through the vinyasa and through Chaturanga Dandasana that you build strength. For instance, shoulder stand and headstand are excellent arm strengthening, upper body strengthening asanas that do not tighten the muscles up. And they bring flexibility while strengthening. So there you have it. I hope this helps.